think this is a woman?
What? Oh. I can't hear you, they can't hear you.
Okay, fair enough. Alright. How many people are watching? Are there any people?
Seven.
Oh, alright, cool. This is a warm-up between Seffy and Fuli Cool.
Murphy Fox.
Now we can actually get into the sets. We have a question about one of the players' age. He answered in halves.
Yeah.
Very remarkable. Connor, for the viewers, how old are you?
Yes.
He is yes years old. We start on Battlefield. Fox B Mark. Double forward air, start up. He's in the sea. Okay. Good edge guard situation. Four. Okay, gets battle with it. Send him. Okay. He's dash stands and we're trying to get the ground. Fully clear your tracks by going up on platforms and then back in. Okay. Up and down. Throwing down here. Okay. Going back to the edge. Oh, that read. Okay. Gets the depth throw. And can he convert? No, he cannot. Nice and air out of up throw. Gets hit by the side beat. Okay, we got a nice ledge guard situation. Very good on Blue Cole's part to wait for the Blue part to happen in order to get the entry. How will Connor retort? Oh, nice down. Nice down. And in 204 it's match. Wonderful kill. Gets in set up by Seffy. Oh, we got the dash dancing game here. Right there. Up tilt. Try to hit him with platforms. Blue Cool is having none of that shit. Up tilt. There. Shiny to backer. Alright. I don't know what I'm doing. He's up there. There. Oh, ledge guard situation. Can he do it? And he does. Good conversion by Seffy. That was really cool retort. First grab, very good. He's got a situation, thoughts on that, very good. It's gone, okay. Change situation. It's ledge cancel on the platform. Candy, dirty. First win taken by second. Two stop. Alright. Oh, it's really, really strict here. In this situation, I would probably go with Dreamland. But we're going with Pokemon. That's also a good choice. Going right into game two. Almost right up here, misses. He's trying to dash around, hopefully go for a forward smash in the reverse, but he ends up being a death attack in this turn. Got some air balance going. Cool, he's not having anything, just decides to stomp this turn. Doing good. We got 82 to 103%. Marth is still alive. Okay. There. Almost right there. Very cool. Okay. Up there. going to forward air. Okay, right there. Shine stalls. Goes back to stage. I need to 170 super saw. Fox gonna get a kill if he gets an throw at this point. Well, Stephanie decides to take the stock. 115%. This is the up tilt on the platform. I'm nearing him off stage. And the end of Sophie's first one. That is the end of Sophie's first one. 9% on blue, please, Fox. I'm nearing to go. Windmill. A bear into back here. Oh, these three up tilts. It was a good charm attempt. No, we cannot get the second up here. Okay. Forward throw. What is he going to do? And a nice edge grab. Forward tilt ended. The stock. Down throw. Air and down tilt. Lots of dash dancing. Lots of dash dancing. They're kind of just going to do the forward dash dance. Got 0 to 10%. Can Marth get a grab? Up tilt. A bear again. Oh my god, he's running the trainer group. How will Marth go join? Very good. Tilt. Here, throw him to the first one. Very good. Come up. How will he convert? Okay. Right there. Forward air. Haggly in the stock. Okay. Oh. Okay. Good edge grab by Fox. 136%. One more thing will take him off. Alright. Nice pummel. We rush back to the forward. Very good. 0% on my final stock. Lock attack. Up there. 50% to 16. Up tilt. Up tilt. Up tilt. Four times. Very good. Martha gets back to stage. Very good grab. Up air. Ooh. Yeah, I know.
It's not ace at all.
Fair enough. I'm sorry. Okay. Fair enough. Alright. Good set too, Seffy. Someone else should get up.
Jump in there.
Oh no, I got a blood. Now it's time to
open up.
Replay one.
Okay.
He barely didn't get like a bunch of KO.
Thank you.
Zephy and Hank.
This game is fun! Peace. Two, 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 two Thank you. Yeah. Oh, well.
Alright. The problem with neutral starts kind of gets awkward.
Yeah. But usually just say go when the seconds hit, you know, some number. But then some people go a second early. So I don't know. Neutral starts stupid.
I agree. The guy says go. Like, why not just
right,
go
just
then?
Just go. Just do stuff.
Yeah.
Derek says hydro.
Oh, what's up, Derek? This is a rematch from earlier today.
It is a rematch of a set that occurred about 2 hours ago.
So either, they both won enough
Amita
games.
Amita won 2-1.
Reeve underscore also says hi to both of you.
Oh Reeve, Reeve. Sorry we missed you today, Reeve.
Yeah, sucks
Reeve.
It couldn't come out.
Yeah.
Team Corn.
Team Corn.
Did Reeve say that?
No, Joey
okay.
Ball again.
Yeah.
I'd be a little surprised if Reeve said Team Corn.
Alright, Zeth's doing a little better job here. He's still going for these up tilts, though. He loves to
up
catch
up. Up tilt's not bad in this matchup.
This went to game three last time?
It did. Okay. It went to FD game three, where Zeth was up and then killed himself at like 10%. So it was a very close set. Until Zeth's killed himself.
That's right, he forward beat. I remember.
That's a scary spot to be in.
Says next time. Reeve says next time.
Yeah. Catch you at the next one, Reed.
We'll be down there in a week.
Yeah. We'll see you next week.
Oh, that was cute. Holy crap.
Yeah, dude.
You see that?
Yeah, he slid off the ledge and aired him.
Because he wasn't facing the right way for back air. Up air's too slow.
Because that's feeling himself a little bit.
Yeah.
Amita,
he had a shot there.
So you see, when Zeth heard that he was going to play Amita, he didn't he was excited for it. And I'm kind of the same way, too.
I love rematch.
Yeah,
ours.
Yeah. But it feels good to, if you go back and beat the guy that already beat you in winners.
Yeah, it's kind of like if you lose again, whatever.
Yeah.
But if you win, awesome.
Yep. So probably the best you can do.
So, Zeth's again playing this kind of campy defensive style.
Yeah, he's going to Rubicon. You're not traveling 30 minutes to your local tournament, but 6 hours to the other one. It's okay, man. We'll steal it. We'll steal all the Kentucky money.
14 viewers.
Solid. That's 12 more than we had like an hour ago.
At this point, everyone's off work. Had a few beers.
Like, this is exponential growth. In like an hour, we're gonna have 100.
Oh man.
And when it gets to me versus Drephen winners finals, man. I don't even know if Twitch can handle it. Anyway, about the match.
Yeah, it's been like 3 minutes and not too much. It is kind of Zeth's playing super safe right now, and Amita's just trying to
Fox should do when he's like in the lead in this matchup, because it's kind of a war of attrition unless you get a rest this puff, and if you're stocked out.
Ready? Go!
Slippy is my least favorite Star Fox character.
Oh, whatever. You need a mechanic, right?
I mean, but you can find another mechanic. They're not that expensive.
Do you value people's jobs as, like, money? Like, currency?
Like, I mean, there's, like, an economic value for each job.
Do you give each and every person you meet an economic value? Do you do this? Because that's a terrible
thing. No. Why would I do that, Drew?
Oh my god, I'm not even gonna ask how much I'm worth. That's not even worth it. Ooh, got some of the rest. Alright, let's see how much he gets off of it.
I think he has the best friends, these are all very expensive.
Alright, yeah, he's gotta play it safe here.
Ooh. Right. Okay. Ooh, good enough.
Yeah. Amita will take those risks too, so I'm surprised he didn't.
Up smash for kill now. Up air will probably kill now. Up tilt still needs like 20%. But, I mean, that's his play anticipation game.
Yeah.
Now it will kill.
Yeah, I think he's gonna kill him with an up tilt, actually. He's been like fishing for that for a while.
Yep. Yep.
He's been keeping his back to him. I think he should keep doing that.
Nice, I'll smash
nice reactions on the forward smash. Alright, so it's 1-1?
It's 1-1. DSR? Okay, whatever.
I guess I'm going back to Battlefield. Yeah, not a good way to start out. Zest misses the VI and gets rusted forward.
Okay, that's probably about as good of a punish as you can get.
You get him with those crazy legs, man. That's like at least like 25.
I'm
20%.
In awe every time it's like a space he gets a fair.
I never know how to use the move. And like they're just like, oh, that combos. I'm like, okay.
I don't know how to use the character.
Yeah. At least a little bit of space animals.
Like,
just a practice.
What would I do if Peach wasn't in this game? Oh, wow, way too high.
Yeah. I don't know, dude.
Probably play Sheik.
Play Ganondorf and lose to Paradigm, probably.
Wow, don't bring up bad memories, Drew. I don't bring up the Sesame Street moon.
Oh, you gave a few birds earlier, so this is making up for that. Zet's really... he's keeping his back to him. I think he needs to overcommit, though, because he's down right now. Oh, nice.
That was a little bit of like an overcommit.
I don't know if he read that or he just threw it out there, but it looked like he knew what he was doing.
At this point, like, overshooting at Moria aerials makes a lot of sense because Amita's probably really accustomed to in the game they're playing right now. Good backer. That's solid.
Yeah.
I guess he could have got res,
I feel like he could have ended it, like, two interactions ago or whatever.
Yeah, on the edge.
Yeah. And, like, that's probably what Hungrybox would have got, you know.
Yeah, but I mean, it's good enough.
It wasn't bad.
Coverage. Got both side platforms.
Alright, nice up B-Bites. That's there. Gonna overcommit, you need to make sure. Make sure you're gonna get it.
I mean, it's safer to overcommit with aerials, too.
Back here.
Weak hits everywhere.
Yeah.
Nice.
Nice
good
up there. And the creamy taunt. Throwing that in there.
Rubbing I don't know if you're gonna make creamy become.
Rubbing it in a little bit with that cream. Yeah.
Sounds disgusting, Drew.
Well, you're making it disgusting. It's not my fault. I'm referring to some sort of lotion. Should we call it like moisty? That's even worse.
That's one
yeah, moist. No, that was even though that moisty taunt. Got him with it.
Gets the upper upper.
Creamy.
I mean, it's usually
another
really
creamy,
good about getting those.
Creamy
though.
Taunt.
Or soggy balls.
Oh.
Okay, no jab.
Yeah, I think Amita's a little nervous with the rest now, but he goes for that. Oh, he botches the ledge guard. He doesn't get punished too bad for it.
Yeah.
But Amita cannot take any more percent here. He needs to finish his stock. He's gonna go, yep.
Is that starting to use side B's for the first time ever?
Yeah, but that's good. I mean, if your opponent's not adapting to it, like, it's going to surprise him in the end. Yeah. All right. Here's
okay.
Stock.
Now, this is so scary.
Yeah, stock of champions-ish.
DI.
Got him with the up throw. Nice job to Amita. Boy, taking over sets again, 2-1.
Another very tense set.
Yeah, he got a lot of up throw rests, which, you know, not always the easiest DI.
Yeah.
But
he got one too when Zets had very slight DI. Like a character link. Who are you playing?
Hey, Papa.
Rick. Nice. Oh wait, so you're in fifth, Papa, at least?
Yeah.
That's solid.
After losing round two.
Oh yeah, you lost to that Peach Cobb. But I mean, you brought your way back. That's cool.
All right, we got Papa Rick. Rick, star of Indiana.
Yeah. Rick, a very scary individual. I'm glad you played him and I didn't.
I always have to take that third seed. You never have to play.
Well, you gotta start beating me, which you will today.
Yeah, sure.
You got this, Drew. You're gonna 3-0 me.
You can't.
No, it's 2 out of 3.
You can't root for me and beat my ass, Hanky. It doesn't work like that.
I chance root for you. And I can take both sides of the issue, you know? Now,
Papa, I think, likes on Fox.
Papa does like this matchup. I think spaces in general, because for a time, a lot of the spaces in OSU were like, oh, Papa, I can beat Papa, and then they don't beat Papa.
Yeah.
So, to some extent, he's analyzed the matchup. He's good at wobbling.
All right, Cleveland Indians has to do. All right, here we go. Yoshi story, first game. We'll see what Rick's anti-ice climber game looks like.
Do they have ices in Indiana?
Maybe. I think Voorhees plays some with them.
Oh, yeah, that's right, Voorhees.
But I don't know if it's, you know, it's a solid matchup for him. Could be. Every Fox, I think, approaches it differently, so... Rick loves just, you know, carrying you across the stage with shines.
Well,
and
with
back
tech air. Skill.
Yeah.
He's so fast.
He loves the ground. He doesn't stay in the air too much.
Okay, Randall's going to give him a chance to recover here. Yeah.
Oh.
Option open.
Problem is the down smash, but here.
That's gonna kill it, yeah.
78% on Yoshi's story.
Pretty much a Sopo stock there.
Yo, those mallets, man. Those mallets are scary. Just one guy, one little...
It's so easy to just DI down smash.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a wobble setup.
Yeah. That's an infinite numbers combo setup.
Infinite numbers. Good ices.
Infinite numbers only did like dash attacks to wobble or up tilts to wobble.
I mean, it's pretty safe, right?
Yeah, but it's not very, you know.
It works.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. It's just not very, I don't know,
mana MVP
flashy. a smash attack or whatever. Up.
I think
he tried to go to the wobble after the handoff, but I don't know if that's like it was.
Got a lot of percentage.
It felt like a little awkward there, but
that's a
good kill. 85, a lot of low early kills.
Yeah, I mean it is Yoshi's.
Yeah. Oh, Nana. Ooh, Nana,
wow,
just
that
say,
grab
no,
is
I'm just saying, like, go ahead, grab him. I'll be here cheering for you. Ooh, Nana with the throw. Alright, Rick getting in there a little bit. Ooh, nice wave or left.
Damn. Good kill on Nana.
But it's Yoshi's story. I mean, like, all Papa's gotta do. Yeah, down smash is gonna. Any smash attack's gonna kill here.
Yeah, Packer might kill.
Yeah, these blast lines are so early.
Ooh, jabbed grab. I like that.
Ooh, nice execution by Rick. Standard Fox stuff. Ooh, got the shine in. And Nana taunted and got shine. And now it's looking a little rough.
Yeah.
We could start Sopo chance if we want to.
Crouch cancel down tilt makes a lot of sense there.
Ooh.
Damn.
Two jabs and a shine.
So scary to DI out there.
Yeah, dude. You DI in, you get him up smash though. So it's like you gotta figure it out. Papa probably want to go FD or something.
Yeah, against Fox, but I'm assuming Rick's going to ban it.
Alright, yeah. Stadium.
That's the one.
Ice Climber is good on these,
Generally, Ice Climbers are good on, like, FD against everyone except Peach for some reason,
yeah.
From what Papa's told me.
Oh, just threw the hammer in there. I don't know if I think that was, like, a missed input for core tilt. Yeah.
Oh!
Alright, we got Mango out here doing 4B stuff. Alright. And, Nana got hit with the back air the exact moment Papa upbeat with his Popo, so, like, he just sat. Nana just stared at him, watched him die off the ledge.
Yeah, sure.
Alright, he did miss it.
And he SD'd out and buffered roll away, which is, I think, what you're supposed to do is to space it.
Papa's always probably going to want to save his Nana.
Yeah.
I don't think, I know, like, Chudat and people try to bait it out, but it's like a trade.
I think you should almost always go for Nana. Like, sometimes, yeah, it makes sense to bait it out because they think you're always going for Nana. But I don't think it's good to not go for Nana that much.
Yeah. Relates to the face.
Oh my god.
Rick's just using that pressure to get in.
I mean, Icy's... so sick. I mean, Icy's don't have very good out-of-shield options, unfortunately.
Oh. Barring Nana against that tree. Oh. You know, and that move's annoying. Oh.
Wow.
I'm not even sure what happened.
Did he get drilled?
I'm not sure. But, Rick's pressure is too much right now.
Rick's pressure is crazy.
Nana with the jab. Is it going to be a 4-stock or is it going to be Papa? Ooh.
Oh, Nana's dead unless... Oh, no. Edge.
Yeah.
Now she's dead.
Ooh, and Papa almost dead. Looking to be a 4-stock here.
Oh, come on, guys.
Nah, that's...
Yeah, there we go. Make it respectable. I mean, Rick's just beating him with the shield pressure. And it's just all over Papa wherever he goes.
Just running around each
other. Yeah, they're having fun frolicking, being a fox and an Eskimo.
That sounds like a Disney movie.
Yeah, doesn't it? Fox, Eskimo making friends together. Fox and the Popo.
Like Fox and the Hound, except, you know, one of them's
Fox,
an Eskimo.
Yeah, Fox and the Popo. Oh, I love doing that stuff. Alright. GG's to Papa and GG's to Rick.
And on the other side is Lance versus someone. Mita.
Yeah, the winners will play each other.
And then we'll play each other.
Yeah. That's true.
We're, getting close. I mean, I... Yeah, I think he is too.
Lance of the Pants beat Fizzle, who's another pup
yeah,
main.
Yeah, apparently it was 2-1, very close. Fizzle dropped game 2. He missed a rest that, I mean, lost him the game.
Yeah, Fizzle usually outplays his Amita, but going right into it. Falco Puff's a little bit different than
Fox Puff.
Yeah, Fox Puff.
Yeah, it's not bad for Falco. You just have to play it a little bit.
Yo, a lot of pups don't know the Falco matchup is the problem. And when they get a Falco, you know, that's not easily gimped by two moves, then they run into trouble. It happens all the time. I think Lance has a good approach game. He plays patient. I think he lacks on his recovery a little bit is when he's down. But
it depends on the matchup. Okay, 106.
Doing a good job spacing with these lasers.
Yeah. I just feel like it's hard to kill in this matchup with Falco.
You think so? I mean, he's got a few options. He's got up smash, he's got down tilt.
Yeah, but like down tilt usually doesn't hit. Up tilt does, but I mean, it's like, what, your one kill move? Okay, and back air. I'm
jab wrong. The back air, that's one, too. Ooh, I don't know what that was, but... Like, there's points where I think, like, Puff, like, can always rest his combo.
Yeah. Yeah,
but they always decide to do like a fair or whatever.
It's just like, I don't know if it's nerves or
well,
if it's just...
I just figured I'd chalk it up to like Jigglypuff's nice power shield to grab.
Good immediate side B.
Yeah, he was aware of it.
I mean, it's Falco. This is like the bad side about the matchup. You can't get a great punch with Falco.
Yeah.
Even though, you know, that wasn't a good punch.
Lance going out there trying to surprise him with that forward smash. Ooh, nice back air.
Yep.
Yeah, nice rest. And got the star KO DI, so Amita doesn't get a punish. Lance looking to play more defensively right now. He doesn't want to take any more percent.
Nothing gets
I would think you would lose lasers here, not really as percentage, but more just combo game.
Yeah.
Because
I can also see it being super frustrating. Like, yeah, the percent doesn't matter that much. The combos are important.
Because I feel like it's really hard just to shoot Puff with lasers. Because she's always in the air dancing around, or she's like crouching. Ooh. Amita going for the...
There's something.
Oh, dancing around the shield. Oh, almost.
He's called the roll for the second time there. He did it earlier in the set too.
Oh, which one?
Like he does like shine dare shine and then he goes past to try to call the roll.
Okay. Oh, nice spacing by Lance there.
Oh no.
He thought his character would be clutch and grab the ledge, but it just fell right through. It happens.
And that's just like the story of Falco.
Yeah, he just misjudged space just a little bit.
You think your character's good, but oh. Good.
Nice down smash. Ooh, nice recovery by Lance, though.
I think downer was an okay option there, because it's an easy fall.
Yeah, dude, I thought
he
was dead. He wasn't even on the screen, dude. He was in that bubble, and then he was on the ledge, because I had the perfect angle for it.
Is that Rastable?
Yes, it totally is. Yeah, Lance needs to clean this up. He having trouble taking this stock.
Yeah.
He was getting a little desperate with forward smashes, but it's not always the case.
I mean, you can't do anything off grab. Yeah. Maybe down throw sometimes, but...
Oop. Mita playing super defensive.
Yeah. I mean, Lance is throwing out a lot of options to try to call his jumps and rolls, but he's just kind of staying chill.
Yeah, he still hasn't hit Mita in the longest time.
Ooh. Wow.
I do like the down throw forward smash with Falco. I think it's really cool, especially if they miss the guy, just slam him right in the face.
Yeah.
He's on stage. Drug box to boo. 171. He's not. And the thing is, throughout the process, that whole last stock, Lance got 105% out of it. So yeah, you got to clean up the stocks, but if you take too much percent,
we rolled up.
Oh gosh, I'm gonna. Oh, alright. Well, Lance.
good enough.
Yeah. Alright, 1-0 Amita. Amita bans Yoshi's Story, goes to Stadium, pretty standard. I like this, I think Jigglypuff's like the worst character on transformations on this stage.
You think so?
Yeah, who, I mean, like legit characters anyway. Oh, got it.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I don't know, I just don't feel like Puff's like, doesn't have really any fast moves, and if she gets trapped in a place where she can't move in the air, it just goes bad for her. Ooh. Gets the right DI this time.
That's restable.
Yeah, there was probably a better option, but it wasn't too bad.
Yeah, I mean, this is fine. Ooh, wow. Interesting forward smash. I didn't really think it was gonna hit.
I got the mountain one. Oop, come on, Lance. Oh, no, you gotta finish it, dude. Yeah.
The transformation kinda messed him up there.
Yeah. He's got that huge wall. I hate being on the left of the wall. I don't like it.
Dude. I don't either. Yeah. But I mean, you're Sheik. You can just Sheik us off.
Whatever, dude. I'll go in the other pit. I'll go in this pit. I love that pit.
And then you say that, but then I throw turnips and you're like, oh man, I really want one.
Oh, yeah.
I can go off
dude.
There anyway.
Oh, dude, I'm like a dog with a bone. You can throw it and I'll just get so distracted. Hi, my name is Doug, and I love you.
I need to watch that movie again sometime.
Up? Fantastic. Yeah, dude. It was that golden age of Pixar. It was that Wall-E, and then Up.
Yeah, and Ratatouille was around that time, too.
Yeah, Ratatouille. Do we play next?
Probably. First, it's going to be the winner of this versus Rick, and then us.
Okay.
That way there's like a break in between the games.
Yeah. Lance still playing to save with these lasers. Gosh. It's like, it just... Every match with Amita, man. he just sits there and like just throws aerials and try to get to reads and then plays super safe.
Yeah.
It's a good strat, but...
Ugh. Ooh, that was a good fake out. And that's a classic Falco combo.
Yeah, nice down air to forward smash.
Run out of jumps, but doesn't matter because Puff is really good.
Amita trying to get something out of that, but Falco took a weird tumble. Ooh.
Wow. That's the right time to get out of the air pressure.
Lance.
Okay.
Lance in the pants. What a great name, man. Why couldn't we come up with Lance in the pants? I wish my name was Lance. That's such a cool name.
I mean, the first Lance I knew was the Elite Four person.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The dragon one, right?
Yeah, the dragon guy.
Yeah. Man, he got scooped up with those back airs.
But he's getting some mileage off these forward smashes. Laser forward smashes, and I guess barely
stick. Okay, yeah, Amita messed it up.
It's definitely Amita's go-to option. Like, try to wave on a platform, grab up throw. Well, here, it probably wouldn't be as good. Probably going for Shinebacker. Had him cornered. But I mean, Amita's more than content to take these trades.
Yeah, and that's all he's doing is just trying to rack up that percent. Do it the safe way.
Ooh,
nice move by Lance. Alright, Lance, let's see what you got.
It worked.
Scary stuff.
Yeah, I like that. I mean, you can come down with an aerial. Kind of looks like he's gonna tomahawk and just shine.
Yeah, Lance needs ooh. Alright, good tech. Still off. Nice, kind of ledge cancel.
Yeah. Ooh, this is gonna lead to something.
Holy crap. Alright, so. Alright, Lance. lands with a prayer. Yes,
gets
nice,
the edge,
nice option.
Gets the edge cancel. Oh! Holy shit!
Ooh, nice job by Lance on that comeback. Called Amita knew he knew Amita was gonna jump up in that air like that.
That was the
through
luckiest side B edge cancel ever.
Oh yeah, he did it though. He brought that back.
Yeah, solid showing by Lance.
Applause for the chat.
Yeah. Probably a Dreamland or Fountain of Dreams.
I'm assuming he's got a banned Dreamland.
Yeah. Fountain of Dreams probably then, which Falco's not too bad on.
What about, is FD good for Falco or Puff?
I don't know, dude. Lance does have a Fox, but...
I'm going back to Stadium.
Apparently, Amita likes this stage because he's a Pokemon. That's the only reason I can come up with.
You get, like, a type advantage.
I mean, it was super close, but, I don't know. Maybe it's preference. Gosh.
Oh.
What he's gonna do here?
I'd be so scared to punch that.
Huh? Yeah, it's a little scary, but like, I don't know. You could do a safe option and just, like, I don't know, add 10% real quick.
Ooh-hoo.
Nice DI.
Grab it too.
I thought that was a rest. Alright. Good job by Lance getting back on the stage.
Ooh, nice
comeback. Man, I love that move. I wish he would get it off. I love down throw to forward smash. Ooh.
Good SDI on this laser. So that was really ambiguous.
I've never been good with Fabulous up throw.
I can't SDI the lasers for crap.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I just do ASDI.
Yeah. Nice.
Woo.
Nice down air to down air combo to finish that one off.
Okay. I like Lance's recovery option, but then you got kind of afraid.
Hey, Zets, do you want to take over for me after this match?
Okay. What's the set count?
1-1.
We won game two.
Lance won.
Amita took him to Pokemon.
Yeah, Lance's counterpick was Pokemon too.
Oh, the run back.
This is looking pretty similar to how it looked last game.
Amita likes doing that, like, we were kind of picking each other back and forth to the same stage in Battlefield as well, so...
Yeah.
Maybe it's a trick he has or something. All Falco?
Yep.
Ooh, nice movement by Nice.
Nice! Nothing.
Alright.
That's the best he could hope for, though.
Oh!
Damn.
Gets him with that sick,
Very slick platform.
Yeah. Gets with the back air, just the tip of his foot.
Is Lance from Indiana?
Yeah.
Indiana versus Kentucky right now.
Oh my.
Rusher.
Okay. I can respect the retreat.
Oh, I like the idea.
I just take the forward smash. That's what he does.
The mango.
Yep. Baited and smashed for it.
Nice cross up.
Yeah. It's like the most annoying feeling. You DI too well.
Nice back here. Alright, Lance in the lead here.
Lance having a killer two stocks here.
Alright, Amita.
Oh.
I want Amita to win the tournament so I look a little bit better.
Oh, yeah. Oh, nice, ooh, nice down throw to down smash.
I mean, you can do some smash attacks after.
Yeah, it matters how the Jigglypuff DI's it, but yeah.
Oh,
ooh,
oh
I thought
yeah,
it was
yeah,
something,
I don't
yeah.
need anything else.
All right,
it's smart of him to back off and not press it.
Alright, does the windmill combo. Ooh, nice forward tilt.
This is smart for me.
Can't rest.
Yeah.
Oh,
I mean, you
can't. Can he chase his stock, rest his stock on the table?
Yeah.
Oh, he can't do it.
But yeah, so I mean...
Yeah, he's spamming.
Okay. Just hit.
Ooh.
Lance, yeah.
Good mix-up.
Uh-oh. Ooh. Ooh. Oh,
okay.
Alright, we still have the rest factor on the table, so...
Not like
Amita needs to get at least a little percent, and,
yeah.
then, and then he'll be good. He just needs like 5-10%. Ah, got him.
Okay. Lance and Rick in loser semis, and you and me in winner's finals.
Lance, you want to do your next match?
Yeah, you two, then us two, then we'll just wrap this
up. Let's take my spot.
You guys want to do honestly, loser semis or winner's finals?
You let her lose your semis.
Yeah.
Do you mind moving over?
That's Ontario Melee?
Sure.
Is it
South Ontario Melee?
Oh, no, not
that
thing. It was in Richmond. Oh, yeah.
Hanky, yeah, be calm.
That's good. I would kind of hope you would.
Yeah, I know. With all the practice I get and
everything. He's not bad. He's like fast neutral.
Yeah, I mean, I just tried to pretend it was you and, like, but, like, give him, like, a little bit less respect. Like, 10%. I got a lot of punishes on down smash.
Yeah, he down smashes too much.
I think so. And his edge guarding wasn't, like, as on point as I feel like he normally would be getting. Oh, so we got the classic Lance of the Pants.
Scoot in.
Is it not picking us up enough?
Oh, lovely.
All right, great. Can we just move the monitor back a little bit, maybe?
Yeah.
I've already had my Wii not thrown.
Sure thing. Well, we can also move back a little bit. That's, I mean, true. It's going to make a marginal difference.
So, it's kind of ridiculous, but this is still best of three, yeah.
Still best of three. Lance in the Pants versus Rick. Loser gets fourth. Winner has a chance to face the loser of you and Drephen in Loser's Finals?
Winner's Finals. Oh, but yeah, in Loser's Finals.
Right, okay.
So I don't know how these two do historically against each other. I know at one tournament I went to last year, it was very close, but Lance beat Griffin.
Really? Yeah. They're both from Indiana, right?
Yes.
They're both so exciting to watch, very technical spaces. We're going to see some good punishes. Like finding a good opening after Lance with that auto cancel back air, and
God.
He just goes out there and gets it. Didn't even need the back air, but we'll take it. It was pretty deep. D Fox would be proud.
Yeah.
Gets the drill. Oh, okay.
Oh, good SDA on those lasers. Wow.
Yeah, that was. You're not gonna follow that up.
Oh.
I feel like he needs to know when you can't get it, so that you can just keep your positional advantage. Because if you whiff that, then everything you just gained by throwing him off stage is kind of gone.
But I mean, I kind of thought he was gonna get it.
Falco mains know when they can and can't get it. I think in his heart he wanted it, but knew he couldn't get it. And he's like, oh, I think I can do it. You gotta
know. We could be playing Val where even if he gets it, it sends them up.
Yeah, that's true. It's true. Oh, God.
Okay.
Oh. And he misses the mid-shorten.
Yeah. You only have one frame, right?
Yeah. They're all one-frame links. But, I mean, that makes it sound a lot harder than it actually is in practice, I feel. Like, I mean, this game has been out for so long. I just feel like after a while, you get this intuitive sense, and it's pretty easy to be consistent with the shortens, in my opinion. Oh, I like how he baited that jump. He didn't go
for
the
immediate goal. Yeah, I feel like he missed the tech skill and it's like, well, he's gonna think he's gonna jump.
Yeah, exactly. That was nice. Oh, if he would have held shield for a little while longer, he could have gotten a shot on the shoe. Yeah, that's cool. He DI'd down to try to get like the edge cancel, but didn't do the side B immediately, the West Pulse.
Yeah.
That's pressure.
Yeah,
wow, Rick is just sitting in his shield. Yep, nice wave dash back. Out of shield to punish that. Yeah, just needs to. Okay. I approve of the laser there. You always gotta shoot one. Because I've actually gotten kills.
Yeah.
If they're not paying attention, like, I've actually, like, shot people off the ledge and then they panic and air dodge and then GG.
But,
like,
there's no downside for going.
Yeah, I mean, you know you're already dead. You might as well just hope that you get a little bit of percent. Wow, nice running shine from Rick. Oh, the ultimate call out, not quite spaced well enough. Is that a runaway pivot off smash? Or did they just wave dash back?
Sure.
Nice spacing, nonetheless. Lance all over him. Rick finds an opening.
Yeah, pulse tech.
Oh, he called the health set. Guess Lance has been taking place a bit too often. Whoa, the power shield.
Interesting.
You can tell that Rick is a pro at this matchup. Nice there. Laser. Ooh, and the down smash. All right. For one, Falco stalk away. Oh man, but Rick knows how to play to his advantage there. Don't commit, wait for something dumb, punish him. Oh, he messed up his tech, so that could have been big. Yep, Rick punished that. Oh,
great angle.
The Mewtwo King angle. Yes, folks, that was definitely Mewtwo King angle. Crazy stuff. Do you think he also buffed the tech? That would be pretty sick.
I mean, I think Rick gets the tech most of the time. I wouldn't be surprised.
I believe it. You gotta take him to... This is the best of three. That's crazy.
Yep.
What do you think the ban was? Either FD if Rick doesn't like chain grabs, or Pokemon if he realizes the Pokemon is probably Falco's best stage in the matchup.
Yeah, I'd probably say FD, honestly. I feel like there are a lot of spaces where I'm really comfortable there. Rick's just a monster at calling out missed techs. Like, yeah, oh, you missed your tech? I'm gonna up air you.
That shrine was a bit spaced to the right. That would have been the stock. Oh. Nice edge cancel, and that's it.
Not yet.
He doesn't take the ledge. I guess he was trying to bait a high angle so he could just punish it on reaction. It's okay to do that from time to time. It's kind of hard to cover everything on reaction. Straight up. Nice coverage from Lance. Waits and reacts. Yep.
Turns around to get the extra distance.
I don't think he needs that. Just wait and back air. I mean, I get that, like, this is on stream and, like, you know, you gotta get some Twitter followers going, but...
Yeah.
Nice call out. Alright. Rick back in it. Nice call out from Lance. It's kind of scary to, like, full jump back air, like, approaching, like, towards a platform like that as Falco, because if you're wrong about Fox jumping up there, then you lost all your stage position.
That's true.
No shorten. I think he needed it there. Nice. Gets the back air, and this is free. Nice. See, that's exactly what he should have done before. Good stuff from Rick. Regaining the lead. Lance is getting a little antsy with some of these full drift down airs in neutral, and Rick's just avoiding them every time. Nice jab reset.
Oh, that really worked, spacing
on the side. I do like these down smashes from Lance. I think he probably should have taken the ledge, though, for the edge guard. No tech. Rick really didn't put himself in a position to cover that. No punish. Oh, misses the right dash out shield.
Okay.
Nice F tilt. Nice. All right, that's exactly what he needed to do before. The adaptation from these guys on their edge guarding is really admirable right now.
Yeah, I mean, they're both good players.
The roll. I wonder if Lance can shield drop.
Yeah.
Goes for the lasers. He misses the mid-short again. I was thinking up B, go high.
I guess that's an option, but like Saipy's kind of safe there as long as you think you can text him.
Yeah, Rick wasn't going to cover it. That was so risky.
Got pushed off too.
I feel like Falco just wants to stay in center stage and make Fox come to him. Good dash dancing, not committing to anything. Baits that out, gets the up tilt.
Oh!
Well spaced back air.
Well timed back air too.
Absolutely. Oh. Ooh, no mango.
That traded.
That was a very nice laser. Calls out the straight up angle, and this is basically even. Falco can't really crouch cancel Nair at this point, though, which is going to be big.
Ooh.
Misses the shine. He's back. Nice shield. Rolls at the right time. Good patience from Lance. Gets a shine.
Here we go.
Oh, he misses it. He still has a positional advantage. Oh, he calls out the jump out of shirt.
Yeah, Rick loves just doing that, like, one dash dance before going in.
Yeah. Just to bait. Oh, that was so fast. Oh, nice back air. Oh, man. Lance does not want to commit. That's it.
Yeah, man, you're all ready.
Good luck.
Okay. I'm going to let him win.
You can go this way.
Yeah, I guess we could.
Should probably go this way.
What's
up, Rick?
Finals, and then
finals grand. Yep. Congrats to Lance. Fourth place. That's really saying a lot considering the talent that we had here.
Okay.
It's cool. We got a couple good upsets. Definitely a good amount of hype sets. Was Fizzle versus Vinsandy on stream? Was, who did Fizzle lose to as winners? I don't remember. Was that streamed? Wow. Alright, another winner's finals between these two colossus. Whoa. Drew, did you just wall jump off of the inside of Battlefield?
Oh, yeah, like
It's so cool to go for. Falco can actually do it too. But if you miss it, you're dead, so. It's no surprise that these guys are winners finals. Did you guys drop any games to anybody? Were there any close games? Oh my gosh. Alright, nope.
I still got like pretty good bracket, but I avoided Rick.
Who did Rick lose to? Oh, okay. That's fair. Did you play Lance?
Yeah, it was 3 stock points.
Oh, really? Did he go Falco?
Maybe 2 stock points. Yeah.
Alright, nobody quite able to put a dent in these two players yet. We're gonna see who is gonna advance to grand finals in a moment. The venue's really starting to clear out. We got here about 11 hours ago. It's 10:24. Drew, just 3-0 him. So Drephen's gonna ban Fountain. I wonder that too. Like, you guys always start on Battlefield for the most part. Sometimes you start on Fountain. Alright, winner's finals of Deluge. May 14th or something like that. Cincinnati, Ohio. Drephen has been putting in a lot of work lately. Let's see if it can culminate into a victory over Hanky Panky for the first time in too long. Great jab, gets the forward air. No float left. Misses that, but lands it back air anyway. Okay. That was a very tight recovery from Hanky to get back on stage with an aerial. Forward throws him off. Gets a turn up. Interesting clank there. I'm interested in the fact that Hanky decided to pressure there instead of grabbing a turn up and resetting neutral. But it seems to be paying off. This is winner's finals. Loser of this will play against Rick in loser's finals. And then the winner of that will play the winner of this in grand. Drephen with the early lead, but that should lead to a stock. Great pressure from Hanky. Oh, he doesn't float far enough to get in front of Drephen to push him back off stage, and Drephen has another shot to get some extra credit. Amazing pressure from Drephen. Hanky just did not know how to respond. It was also fast, too. It's like, I don't even know what's happening. All of a sudden, I'm just grabbed. Oh, he had a free ledge. Doesn't take it. 153. He is going to have another shot at life. Gets a forward air, and he's back. Alright, Hanky not taking too much percent, and this is pretty close to even. Drew whiffing a dash attack, but back to neutral. Lands a tomahawk grab after whiffing some needles. Oh my goodness, that was so patient from Drephen. Not... He didn't even want to punish the air dodge, just waited for the option Hanky was going to spam afterwards and punish that. Very smart play. Oh my god, these space back airs. Drephen with a full stock lead. Alright, that trade. Drephen will take that all day. Nice boost grab. Gets the platform tech chase. Will he get another one? Good DI from Hanky to end the punish. Oh, and that's gonna do it. 2-stock lead for Drew. No tech. Hank is going to capitalize off of that. Again, nice pressure, and that's going to be the stock. Very good work from the one and only Hanky Panky. MIOM hidden boss in the flesh with the peach and the dress. Oh. Nice wave dash back to bait that flow canceled aerial, and Drephen's going to capitalize. Wow. This is not looking good for Hanky in game one. Another forward air. Can he get to ledge? And that's it. All right, good stuff to Drew. Hanky did tell me before the set that he was going to let Drew win. Alright, Hanky going to Dreamland. I agree with it. Most of Sheik's kills are going to be either off the top or off the side. It's not quite as common that Sheik will actually be able to gimp Peach or that she'll die off the bottom. So Dreamland's going to give Hanky so much more longevity, whereas Peach is really just trying to edge guard Sheik, since Sheik's recovery is not quite up to par with Peach's. Nice. Good DI from Drephen. Yeah, not quite as good. Peach's recovery is so godlike. Alright, Hanky does in fact drift far enough to push him off stage, and that was a very dominating stock from the Hankster. Drephen going all the way up there for the invincible punish. I like that late aerial to jab. Goes for a grab, and Hanky actually down smashes that time. So it seems as though he's already beginning to adapt to this janky shield pressure that Drephen's employing. Nice power shield. What will Hanky get? Goes for the back throw. Hanky loves his positional advantage. If he can throw you off stage, grab a turnip, he'll take it 9 times out of 10. Drephen trying to find a way in. He's got a turnip. Hanky with a very well-spaced dash attack. Oh, nice air dodge from Drew. Hanky put himself in a good position to punish on reaction. It's so hard to cover things and still put yourself in the position where you can actually cover Sheik's air dodge. And that's an option that Hanky is well aware that Drephen is going to go to very, very often. Not the best DI gets sent clear to the other side of the stage. And this is looking very difficult for Drew. Very nice Mewtwo King wall jump back air. And that's it. That was unfortunate. Is Drew gonna fight? Gets the back air. Oh, wow. Interesting trade. Definitely favoring Hanky as he continues to get some extra credit on still his first stock. I can't believe how late that aerial was and the fact that Hanky actually didn't throw anything out to protect himself. Drephen very clearly floated into Hanky's range for a good while. And we're not seeing a 4-stock, we're not seeing a JV. Is it going to be the clean 3? The trace. Goes for down throw. I was expecting back throw to try to go for a gimp. If you're still fighting at this point, I feel like you need to try to go for the high risk, high reward stuff to put yourself back in it. Doesn't get the edge cancel. That was actually pretty close though. I haven't seen a Sheik edge cancel anything since like Mewtwo King took a game off of PP in Grand Finals of like Apex 2014 or something on FOD. Literally the only time I've ever seen it. Nice. Alright, Drew's got another chance here to take yet another stock. Hanky's back. Whiffs the boost grab, and yeah, that's it. Well, once Drephen was put on his last stock, I mean, it was looking pretty even there, so it looks as though Drephen's already adapted and is figuring out something. He's going to have Yoshis for his counterpick, and if he can win this, he'll have a counterpick going into a potential Game 5 should he lose Game 4. This is where you're going to see much earlier kills on Peach. Her longevity is not going to be nearly as superb on Yoshi's. Nice roll away from down smash. Not trying to get blended right now. Hanky all over Drephen. Drephen going for a needle turnaround in neutral to get a back air. Kind of reminiscent of how Spacey's will do shine turnaround to get back airs. And oh, nice tech on Randall. And Livin, nice edge cancel there, and we're back. Doesn't catch the turnip. Drephen is a master of utilizing Randall. It's actually quite uncanny how often Randall comes to his aid. Oh my goodness, that almost worked. Hanky must be shaking his head. Interest, again, utilizing Randall though is probably a bit unnecessary. Somehow not gonna kill it, 143%, and that will do it. All right. Hanky only at 29%. Nice shield drop back here from Hanky. These two players have become so proficient at shield. And that will actually kill at 77%. It's not often you see Peach die at that percent to any character, let alone Sheik. So good stuff to Drew, pull himself back into this one. Interesting, so in the course of these guys' friendship and their time playing one another, I've time and time seen Drephen shielding Hanky's down smashes and not getting any punish. Nice power shield grab. That time he elects to full jump after he shields the down smash and actually needle. I always thought that he should be wave dashing out of shield, and I don't know. It actually worked out well for him, so maybe that's an actual punish for Sheik. We'll have to see if Hanky can avoid it next time. good reaction from Drephen to go in for the grab. That's not going to kill. He just needs one more aerial. Unable to punish that whiff down smash because it landed on the platform. Another crouch cancel down smash from Hanky at 118. Jab can get crouch canceled until absurdly high percents. Rolls behind Drephen. That won't kill. I think if he hits him with that one more time, it might kill him. He really just needs one solid hit. He's got to know that Hanky's going to be spamming shield. That trade will do it. 59%, not too bad for Drephen. Still definitely in this. He just down tilt hits unusually hard. I believe that was a stitch. It was a stitch. All right. There is a chance. Gets the wall jump. And Hanky again messing up that edgeguard. Not going to matter. Drephen down one stock on his counter pick. Gets a grab. Misses that. Reacted a bit late. That trade's favoring Hanky. Goes for the dash attack. Doesn't get the read on stand straight up after having missed a tech. Dash attack. He overextended a bit. Falls off the platform. Elects to reset the neutral instead of trying to punish that whiff down smash on shield. Trying to play as safe as possible. Not take any more percent. That is probably going to... Yeah, you can't reach ramp, unfortunately. Alright, let's see if we're going to see a run back. And we've got your boy...
Yo, this is your boy's co-host here, Deep Fox.
We got Deep Fox on the mic as well, Mal. How you doing, man?
Doing well, how about yourself?
Doing very well. So happy to have you here, man. Today's been such an awesome day.
It's nice to be here at LCL.
We're seeing a really, really high-level set right now, and what's cool is...
This is fun.
Drephen took a pretty convincing game one, and Hanky seems to have turned the tides ever since then, so... I don't know if Drephen's going to... Oh, Drephen's actually going to FD. Alright.
FD boys. This is a nice setup we got back here.
Yeah. Yeah, this is, it's like we esports now or something like that.
Something.
So, you're hanging out with, the Indiana guy, right? He's Deep Fox.
Yes. Okay, we're getting popular.
Yeah, dude, the chat's loving it. You're getting all the shout-outs in the world.
Yeah,
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, how's Rick and Swank last night? I think
Rick nice.
And Lance in the pants and Swank
are stopping back.
Tonight. Yeah, yeah.
Back over to your place in Dayton.
Yeah, it's just cuts about an hour off the trip. I think.
Oh, that's nice. That's really nice. Yeah, Drephen came over and hung out with you guys last night, right?
For sure. Yeah, yeah. He was there. Yeah.
Oh, nice tech from Hanky, and it's not gonna matter. Great coverage from Drephen on that.
All right, here you go, Drephen.
It's unfortunate because after Peach gets a tech like that, she doesn't have any other options aside from just immediately up B again. He could have potentially fast fallen and tried to sweet spot it. So that's something that we might want to see if Hanky will employ in the future. All he can get is a grab here. Bad DI. And that's gonna do it.
Yeah, I was.
I don't know why he would have.
He would have had a, it would have been an edgeguard situation, but.
The deepest of foxes.
I'm going Smash Brothers.
From the Smash Dog. From the new unreleased Smash Dog. The phenomena sweeping the Smash Nation. Take the ledge. Doesn't take ledge. Let's drive him back for free. Punishes the ledge hop aerial. Fantastic crouch cancel. Great shield from Hanky. Amazing presence of mind to understand that he needed to block that approach. That was better DI, but unfortunately at that higher percent, nothing to do. Nice wave dash back. Trying to bait something. Unable to actually capitalize. Oh, invisible through that entire thing. Can he DI far enough away? I was expecting Hanky to try to drift off stage because Drephen didn't have any stage to run. Hanky says it's worse. I'll take his word for it. He's the one in winners finals, not your boy or Deep Fox, unfortunately. But to be fair, you didn't even enter, so for all we know, you would be in.
I missed registration.
That's so unfortunate.
Yeah. I mean, I could have registered at the door, but paid an extra $20 to play with people I play with all the time.
Yeah, I mean, you could just play friendlies with us,
I did. It was a great time.
It was.
There was a lot of cool people.
Yeah, I'm definitely looking to try to get a money match in with Rick at some point. I don't know if we're gonna have time though, because he's got losers finals and then. This is actually pretty close. Gets the correct DI.
What are we gonna do?
Good drift. He held down for just a bit too long.
That's tricky. That's tricky to do.
Yeah, it is. And it's kind of scary too, because it's just a bit counterintuitive.
It is, because if you mess up.
Yeah, but if you don't, you're dead anyway, so you kind of have to. I'm surprised Drephen didn't elect to try to catch that dot eyes. I could have really turned the tides of this match. And Hanky won't stock away. Oh, he runs right into that down smash. Hanky closing in on a 3-1 victory. Drephen trying to push it to a game 5. Yeah, D-Fox, go to room tomorrow. Is there a fan in there? Oh, nice. Spot dodge from Hanky, and that's making this look a little less surmountable for the documentary kid. This has got to be a kill. All right. 96%.
No, that's totally doable.
This is definitely doable. He's going to have to outplay him, but this is doable. Catches the turnip. Nice back air. Spot dodge. Gets a grab. Guaranteed punish. Oh, 35% just like that. Now Hanky has his own punish. Back throw. Hanky gets a turnip. Nice needles. Charges a bit of needles. Nice power shield. Gets back to center stage with the double roll. So 2017. Oh,
stage.
Hanky is spot dodging every one of these boost grabs, and that is gonna be... No, nice. He gets the DI, and he has one last chance.
What are we gonna do?
He gets the ledge. We got some Chino stalling. 152. Oh. That's Chikorita percent, boys. And dies off the top. Hanky taking yet another set from Drephen, 3-1. Drephen's gonna face Rick in Losers Finals
Rick,
and winner of that.
This should be a run back.
Oh, yeah? Yep, how was the winner's semi set between them?
It was a pretty good set. It was looking good for Drephen, though.
Right. So, yeah, it was 3-5. Rick fought his way through losers and has finally earned the right to play a 3-out-of-5 set after having just actually beat Lance in the Pants 2-0.
Yeah, everything was best of threes in the interest of time. So.
And it's understandable. It is.
Yeah, it's all good. I mean, you know, the one-day tournaments are a luxury nowadays. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Apparently back in the day, like, standard was 2-day tournaments.
I mean, dude, you know how many events we threw tonight? There was an informal Smash 64 doubles. There was a 64 through.
That was informal?
Yeah, it wasn't like planned. They just kind of did it. There was 64 singles,
man,
64 through.
They were over that in that corner.
Dude, 64
they looked like
is
they were just
lit.
Stuck in a corner. That's so cool. I got
yeah.
to play with some 64 players. Amida.
Yeah. Yeah, he ended up winning. Too. He's pretty good. Pretty freaking good. But anyway, we're going straight into it. Losers Finals, Drephen and Rick. This is the run back. I believe it was a 2-0 victory for Drephen in winter semis. Oh, what a read on Rick's part. I don't know about that back air. You think if he would have drilled again, he could have gotten a bit better pressure going on the shield? Oh, doesn't get the shine turnaround back air. It's just stuff Drephen's recovery. Good DI. Oh, but no tech. I can't believe that didn't hit. Drephen rarely misses that.
That's super tough, though.
Wow, he lands there and gets an immediate shield. Rick is showing that he can actually compete with Drephen in the neutral, which is not something we see often. I don't think he needs to be going for risky edgeguards of that nature. Just take ledge.
And what are we going to do? Okay.
There it is. Nice.
Good option.
I was thinking maybe up air, stand up, up smash, but it's all mixed up on DI.
I mean, when Sheik's at real high percent, I think that's a preferred jump a little bit above her and come down with a back air.
Yeah, because if you just rinse, wash, and repeat that, there's literally nothing she can do.
I've seen some of them, smash DI out of the up air when I do it for the second time.
That's true, yeah.
And they see it the first time, they're like, all right, I'm going to smash DI then.
So maybe you might want to mix in the up air every now and then, but make the back air kind of your go-to.
Always good for mix-ups.
Nice DI to snap to ledge there for Rick.
Right.
Drephen's so good at stuffing Fox's approaches, just in general. Oh, he's missing these techs and inputting kind of these like desperate get-up attacks.
Nice
tech, doesn't matter. He does.
Yep,
very, very nice. Oh, doesn't end up getting the drill. That could have been a kill if he would have just wave shot him once or twice. Take ledge. Up air. And that's it.
Nice.
Rick going even with Drephen right now.
Can do it.
You heard it straight from Hanky earlier. He said that he kind of got bracket luck in the sense that he got to avoid Rick by letting Drephen actually eliminate him from winners instead. So if there's a player that Hanky would be a bit afraid to play that's not Drephen, I think you're looking at him in losers finals. What's up, Papa?
One and only.
What's up, deep facts?
Deep facts.
Show me the deep facts.
The deep facts?
What is this?
Show me the deep facts. Oh, he waits for the tech in place, but doesn't quite space his up air well enough. Nice DI. Gets center stage. He's trying to wall out Drephen's approach. I like
nice
it.
Down.
Take ledge. Nice. Take ledge again. Still doesn't have a jump. Oh, nice. Forward air from Drephen. This is game one. Gets the edge cancel, nice back air, needs to get to ledge. And Drephen with a rare miss on that. Of course, we all know that that is his favorite recovery option, but
course.
You don't often see him kill himself with it. Nice. Gets the up smash.
Oh.
Drephen is so good at calling out when you're going to commit to some action.
I might have gone to the grab there at a shield instead of the up smash.
Yeah. Oh. Oh. And this is going to be big for Drephen. Oh, no, this is props. Oh, fantastically smart recovery on Rick's behalf.
Who's out with that nair?
Rick looks like he's getting a bit antsy. He just wants to end this. Drephen's so patient. He's not going to let it go down like that. Ah, that back air. Nice. Wait for it. Take ledge. He was in the air, so you can't convert the wave shot, and that's going to be it. Such a close match. Heartbreaking for Rick to go down like that, but he's going to have his counter pick.
Drephen's a fortress, dude. He just... He's at last stock, and he's never out.
Dude, he just... He's so clutch. Like, he doesn't, like, panic. He doesn't do anything dumb. He just waits for you to panic and do something dumb every time. His patient play style is just... It's an enigma for players below his level.
Nice
crouch cancel. Unable to follow up. Oh. Good smash eye from Drephen. Well-spaced back air. Takes the trade. Spot dodge down smash. The bane of many a spacey player's existence. Nice waveland back for Rick. That's going to be the stock. Oh no, he didn't realize he was above 100%. You have to ledge dash or just ledge hop an aerial there.
Yeah, above 100%. Get him slower.
I do think he's being a bit overly ambitious with some of these edge guards going off stage. Drephen is going to punish him for that.
Yo, shout out to Papa.
Shout outs to Papa off cam.
Yeah, he's right here.
They definitely could hear us like saying Papa. Super neck. Sup, Nate? Rick definitely holding his own. This is very impressive. Goes for short hop up air. Yeah. Drephen definitely has to be a little mentally exhausted after that set with Hanky. But he's got a really good lead now. You know, we haven't seen many lasers from Rick, and it's clear that he's not the kind of campy fox that's gonna do that, but...
No, he gets in there.
I do think that if he were to employ a bit more and force Drephen to approach him more, neutral would go even more in his favor. Alright, keeps him in the corner. Nice nair. Another good laser.
See,
he needs to stop committing on these edge guards if he wants to be able to put himself in a position to punish Drephen's air dodges back to the stage, just like that. Take ledge. Nice turnaround back there, and that's it. Hits him with some lasers just cuz. Amazing waveland. Such good movement. It's so hard to execute with Fox, especially in a tense situation. This is all nice. I feel like he probably should have taken the up smash at some point. There it is. There's the patience we needed. And beautiful. Reminiscent of Mango versus Plup. That was kind of sick.
It was. And in the same place.
Was that a 0-to-death? I think that was a 0-to-death. Rick attempting to run away with this game. Drephen in a bad spot. Gives up ledge. Finds himself on ledge. Nice ledge dash. Drephen really likes going for that full jump down air read on you just like standing straight up if you miss attack.
That.
He loves that. And Rick's not giving it to him. Rick is just rolling away every time. Up tilt, up air. There it is. All right, a quick two stock for Rick.
Drephen misses reaction type chase. Yeah.
That is so impressive. Clean indeed. Hey!
Oh my God. Whoa,
Rick, you did it! Alright, and we're gonna go to Fountain. Yeah. Understandable. Running Shine Grab. Oh, and he covers it. Oh, falls right into Drephen's arms. This is gonna hurt.
Loving arms.
We haven't seen a lot of reaction tech chases from Drephen. It's mostly just edge guards and straight hits.
Yeah, it's hard to get a grab though.
Yeah. The way that Rick plays, I mean, his pressure is so tight, his spacing is good.
Yeah, he gets in and he gets out.
It's so hard to deal with Drephen when he has you with your back to the wall, you're in shield, and he's just tilting in the space you want to go to. You've got nowhere
super
to run.
Tight. If you jump, he's just going to fair you.
Exactly.
He wants you to jump.
I think Drephen might have actually been dead there. I don't know if he actually made it to the stage. Up smash. Charged it. All right. Rick with this arguably with his first lead of the set right now. Not quite gonna make it. Your boy's getting a call from his girlfriend, she's gonna have to wait. These reaction tech chases, though. Oh! Drephen with a rare miss. That typically converts to 70-80% or a stock for Drephen. It's so unfortunate. That's such a slow tech roll. Oh, I feel like he should just back air him and try to edge guard. Forward air,
yeah,
that's gonna do it.
That position is tough. You have your shield up, the platform is lowering into his up tilts and F tilts. Oh my gosh.
Rick getting a little impatient. Up tilt, up air. Not gonna kill on fountain at least. Finds another trade. This is it. Definitely didn't need all this, but nonetheless, right, it secures
works,
the stocks.
Make sure an up smash with that.
Yeah. If you can execute that quickly enough,
you gotta be quick, yeah.
There's probably no like reason it's better than up smash, but I mean, I don't know. That's what you wanted to do. It works just the same. No DI, and that's gonna do it. Drephen's not letting back.
Yep.
Alright, this is a big moment. Drephen only at 14%. Rick looking like he wanted a running shine to... Oh, and no mid-shorten. We saw Lance missing a couple mid-shortens against Rick earlier, so... Karma coming back. And... Rick down to... He's got FD. And we're gonna see FD. Arguably the best stage in the matchup for Fox.
Yes, that's what I choose.
Yep. Once you get Sheik in the air, it's pretty difficult for her to regain neutral. Kind of like when Marth, you know, gets Sheik in the air and juggles her.
Yep, but just the same right here. Drephen, he keeps you
with
the
double
chases,
shine.
Got a nice
that's
double
it!
Shine. That'll do it.
That was insane. That's all Fox needs. And with this lead... Is Rick going to resort to a more defensive, campy playstyle, or is he going to keep trying to keep the pressure on? That was nice.
He's going to keep that pressure.
Amazing pressure.
Nice, yeah. He's keeping that.
Gets a back air. A little impatient there. I kind of like to, like, bait something. I was going
to
say, like, after he got, like, that last back air. Oh, nice late back air. Oh my god, he gets there. And right now, this is looking like we might see a game five. Drephen has something to say about it, though. He gets some needles. Only down a stock. Rick shoots some lasers. He knows he doesn't have to approach. There's no reason he should be approaching. Unless he gets in like this. Oh, no grab. I would have liked it for shine grab there.
Yeah. I messed up his room.
The F-tilt certainly wasn't on purpose, and Drephen's going to make him pay. Picks up the...
Yep.
Yeah, wow. And just like that... A player like Drephen, he was just down two stocks and all of a sudden it's even. So disheartening when you have that kind of lead and all of a sudden it's just gone.
That's this game all the time.
I know, it really is. Drephen playing the long range game with these needles. Rick really just wants one shine to get a big punish. Oh no, these dash attacks.
The dash derby.
No, he gets the
dash derby.
And Drephen pulls out the recovery. Three stocks in a row for Drephen and he's trying to take this in four games. He gets it. Good air dodge. Oh, Rick doesn't know what to do. Oh, he's going to spot dodge that approach every time. He's so good at that.
That's a tough position here.
He needs to get center stage. Quit trying to fight. Just get center stage. Drephen backers him. And that's probably going to be it. No, I think he fast fell. Really great showing from Rick. Fantastic moments there. He's going to end up in third place. And with... Considering how stacked this tournament was, that's still an incredible feat.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, and we're going to see the rematch. Can Drephen do it?
Wait!
I need to rewatch that.
All right, the matchup we all probably thought was going to happen. Another hand warmer. This is Grand Finals. No upsets today. At least not quite yet. You know, we've been here for nearly 12 hours at this point. We've been here for nearly 12 hours, and I would be okay with staying another 30 minutes to see Drephen take this home.
Yeah, except the guys that came with, they're leaving.
Yeah, that's a bit of a predicament right there.
Ah, they're fine.
That'll be fine. Hanky, do you think you're gonna win? Not the most confident we've seen Hanky Panky.
These guys are trying to get out of here. Yo, it was fun commentating.
Yeah, thanks so much,
we'll do it again soon.
The deepest later, of guys. Boxes. Have a good night. Seffy. Seffy, let's go, man. Grand finals. GFs. Set one. There we go. All right. We are getting local resident Marth main TTB Seffy. Maybe eventually at some point we'll come on the mic. What, were you joshing me or what? Commentate with me, bro. This is lame. There we go. All right. And your tag?
MatchStick.
MatchStick, absolutely. All right, and we're already going into it, set one.
Oh, this is going to be good.
So we met at the 64 tournament, right?
At 16-bit?
Yeah.
Yeah, I believe we did.
Yeah, that's right. Like, was that last summer?
Yeah, it's been a while.
It has been, man. How you
16-bit's
been?
not too keen on hosting events too often.
Yeah, you know, we've been moving a lot of the 64 and other Melee-like events at Old North Arcade.
Yes.
I don't know if you've heard about that.
I'm actually there twice a month doing their semi-running their Mortal Kombat 10 and Street Fighter 5 tournaments. Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah.
If you'd be interested, you should consider getting in talks with some of our TOs, SuperNAC, in the chat. We have a lot of 64 events. We'd love to have you if you'd be interested in collaborating a bit.
Yeah, absolutely. I need to get myself a composite switch, but sure, I'd love to.
Yeah, all right. Well, we'll definitely talk about that at some point.
Sure.
Hanky with a brief lead here in game one of Grand Finals. Hanky coming from winners. Drephen winning a surprisingly close set in losers finals against Rick, 3-1.
Yeah, Drephen's fighting uphill at this point. He's already fought. Hanky once.
Yeah, he's been going through a gauntlet, and Hanky is just coming off of, you know, a break, some time to relax, like, calm the nerves. And I'll be the first to admit, you know...
What nerves?
What nerves? No, I brought both the TV and a setup. Yeah, this is mine. Do I get, like, a refund for that or something? Oh, also, yeah, that's my TV. Yeah, that's my TV and my setup. So if you want to, like, put that back on the table? All right.
Okay. Drephen closed the life lead there a little bit on Hanky. All
right, great. Thanks so much.
Oh, block the darts.
And again, every time Drephen shields a down smash from Hanky, we're not seeing a wave dash out of shield grab punish, which I'm fairly certain every character is capable of doing. We did see last set in Winners Finals, he did a full jump needle grab, which was pretty interesting, but I don't know if it's as guaranteed. So, it's interesting because both these characters, or both these players rather, are technical.
Ooh.
Thanks so much. Absolutely.
It amazes me how people continue to find tech in this game after 15 years.
Did third in teams get any money, or was it just first and second? What? Yeah, that's fair.
Oh, by the way, everybody, hi. I'm the guy who's
seventh.
I'm the guy who's been running the stream all day, so this will be the first time, aside from anyone who joined us in the first 30 seconds of the stream, of actually seeing my face. As such, I am not over there at the chat, so all of your questions, comments, etc. will be going unanswered for the duration that I am over here.
That they will.
So, sorry, but so
you might as well keep them to yourself, folks.
Yeah.
Or interact with one another.
Chat it up. More interactions.
And we'll have a... What's the feature on Twitch now where, like, when you rewatch VODs, they save the chat for you? That's pretty cool, right?
I hadn't heard of that, but that's awesome. They're actually starting to do a lot more interaction-based stuff, too. So, I mean, that's the tip of the iceberg, from what I understand.
Yeah.
And from what I understand, YouTube is starting to think about bringing back, like, video comments on things as well.
Really?
Yeah. That could only be good.
Oh, yeah. I can't imagine that going wrong. It's just incredible to see how far just esports in general have gone over the past couple of years. Like, even just, like, 3 years ago, I mean, we were in Evo 2013, and, I don't know, like, it wasn't nearly like this. And
yep.
I don't know, the difference that 3 years can make.
Indeed. Well, Drephen, here they go again.
Yep. Drephen going to Pokemon. Can't say I disagree. Nice tomahawk platform grab.
Tell me about Pokemon. That's why is it a good stage for certain characters?
Okay, so Pokemon has the second lowest ceiling in the game.
Ah.
Next to Yoshi's, but it's wider. So Yoshi's is really good against Peach because, you know, you want to be killing her off the top since she's so light. That's one of the easiest ways to kill her.
Right, otherwise, her lateral recovery is crazy.
But the thing is, Peach is just a wall of defense. So when you're on Yoshi's, there's not a lot of space to try to outspace her. And for that reason, neutral can be a bit harder. Pokemon is also actually the longest, as in widest, legal stage in the legal rule set. It's actually wider than both Dreamland and FD, and that's a common misconception that people think either of those stages are the widest. So you have a lot of room to try to outspace Peach, and you're going to kill her at lower percents.
I see. All these guys are riding about even. Oh, nice. First stock goes to Drephen.
Yeah, but Hanky's definitely not far behind.
Oh,
nice needle grab.
No, not at all. I'm fairly certain anything close to 100 is a death sentence at this level.
Drephen with a fantastic 70% punish on Hanky right now. So much extra credit. Yeah, and once Drephen missed the DI on that first hit, there's nothing.
Not off-scene up air from Peach.
Yeah, exactly. You don't often see her killing with that move, but great wall jump tech from Drephen to get out of that situation.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Ooh.
That was crazy.
During the
Hanky
skirt.
Hanky not happy about that one.
Not a bit.
Will Drephen get legend
ability?
Oh! Oh my god, I just realized what happened. Drephen has a stitch face. Drephen has it. What will he do with it? He's jumping around. Hanky's scared. Hanky's scared.
Hanky gets wasted.
Hanky doesn't know what to do. Hanky's laughing. Will Hanky go for the... Oh
my god!
Hanky might as well just forfeit. Just put down your controller, dude.
Just from shame alone.
Oh, another stitch.
No. Ooh.
Alright.
Drephen's gonna have to watch those spot dodges.
Despite all of that, Hanky really is not that far behind, but are we gonna see another huge punish from Drephen? Goes for back throw. Hanky's throw choices confuse me sometimes.
Sleepy turnip.
Ooh.
Oh. No, he's gonna make it. He's gonna make
it. Dak crouch cancel.
Ooh.
Gets the second hit. He's gonna have another opportunity for life.
Yep. Oh, edge guard into the death.
I mean, yay! Go, Hanky! Good stuff.
Oh.
Again, Drew has been trying to bait people into standing straight up, and it's just not working. Like, every time he gets somebody knocked down, he'll jump straight up and try to come right back down on them with that down air, and I haven't seen anybody fall for it yet, so it's definitely an awesome mix-up if he gets the read, but I think he needs to be reading these rolls.
That was an amazing catch.
Dude, that's standard for Drephen. Like, that's literally standard for him. On his recovery, he will catch the turnip, he'll grab the ledge, he'll come back with the turnip. That's just what Drephen does.
And what Drephen do?
Is this a kill? Hanky DI'd to force a forward air instead of an up air. I really
that
thought
was a collision of four forward airs right there.
Yeah.
Clearly, Hanky.
Oh my god! You see this?
I'm seeing it.
Do you see this?
What are the odds on the stitch just base?
Hanky, just give this game to him, man.
Oh!
Doesn't even want it. He doesn't even want it again. And what's insane is that that's the second kill this game that Drephen has gotten with the stitch, and he's not even that far ahead. Hanky really hanging in there. He's going to have to transform to Zelda if he wants to make this one.
Oh, I forgot.
Never
Wait,
mind.
What?
This oh, commentator right, was right. completely wrong. Nice back air. Said the commentator. Oh.
Drephen is pulling out all the stops on this one.
He's looking super fresh. Mighty fine. All right, all right. 59% on Hanky. Can he get a 2-0
solid lead?
Or are we going to see the 1-1? Drephen playing perhaps too patiently right now. Hanky capitalizing.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, this is looking like an even ball game. No catch in the turnip. He gets the ledge dash. Doesn't electro roll through Hanky. He can't make it to the platform.
Good guard.
And
forward air.
He DI'd that so far away.
No.
All right. Nice power shield.
Good hit.
Wave dash is back, but Hanky is trying to get out of there.
Oh, and down. Can he convert? Nope.
The trade.
The trade.
I don't know who that's benefiting at this point. Probably Peach.
As long as it's no one, then we get to give
him a show. Oh, and there it is. Hanky breathing a sigh of relief as he secures game two.
Hanky calms his heart as he and Drephen prepare for the next round.
So... can Drephen take 3 in a row? Sorry, Papa. I'm just telling it like it is. You're not known to drop walk. I know. Alright, so now we're seeing Yoshis.
Yep, now we're Yoshis.
So we're going to see how these interactions differ a bit. Again, we're going to see Peach dying slightly earlier, but he can command so much of the stage with just one dash attack, one down smash, that Drephen has to be that much more careful in the neutral game.
Is her dash A that safe that she can just throw it out like that all the time?
Not really. Like, if Drephen shields it, he can get a grab and follow up off of it. But that's just the nature of the mix-up because, you know, if Drephen decides to try to shield what he thinks is going to be a dash attack, Hanky can grab that shield. So they're constantly
Smash
in this...
Smash eats the air A barrage.
And all of a sudden, Drephen down to his third to last stock of winners. Or losers, actually. Of the entire turn. Misses the forward air. Really nice walk away.
Oh, good catch on the ledge there.
Oh, he really wanted that. And we've seen him in an earlier set. We saw him kill Hanky at 77% with that up smash on this stage, which is quite absurd. Nice power smash. Power shield, excuse me.
Don't worry, folks. There's not an earthquake. Someone's just moving a table in the background.
Yeah, it's actually quite reminiscent of an earthquake, and that's going to do it.
Floors.
49%, not too shabby for Drephen.
This is completely doable still.
Hanky successfully reading that Drephen was going to up there to try to avoid those invisibility frames.
Drephen poking out those jabs.
Drephen is giving up a lot of position. Sometimes when he thinks he can get a forward air, but he can't, he'll whiff it, and then Hanky can actually capitalize and flip the entire script.
Oh, nice.
Oh, wow. Hanky first to the punch there. Oh, he didn't catch it.
Oh, the cloud.
Dude, Drephen, like I said earlier, is one of the best utilizers of Randall that I have ever seen.
Randall?
That's what the Smash community calls the cloud for some reason.
I see.
Maybe it's because he's random. I don't know.
That could work.
But the thing is, he's actually not even random. Like, he actually goes based on a timer.
Yeah.
Nice. And the up air.
Miyamoto doesn't want anything random in his family games. That would ruin them.
Absolutely.
What if you just fell over at the crazy times? That would be stupid.
Yeah, I know. Like, they would surely never make a game like that.
It could ruin an entire game generation.
Absolutely. Oh. Drephen with the opportunity to even up the score. Okay, there was the same exact scenario earlier where he would have went for the fair even though he couldn't have gotten it. Instead, he just backs off and keeps his position, and I like that from Drephen. That's not too bad. He gets back.
No, he's still there. As long as he's there, he can do his work. Time to go to work.
These power shields are so good. Crazy wall jumping. And yeah, nothing he could do there. Drephen on his last stock. Is this going to be a 3-0?
How long until they're basically robots, do you think, these players?
I don't know. I feel like, in a sense, they're already there. Oh, and Drephen finally trying to go for the wave dash out of shield punish on having shielded a down smash. Is it too little too late?
Oh, good grab. Zombie
and
turn.
And that's it.
Come on, Randall.
All right, and that concludes Deluge.
Well, congratulations to Hanky Panky.
Hanky Panky taking it with only having dropped one game the whole tournament. The reign of Hanky is far from over. If you thought tax season was getting in the way of this guy's clocking in and out, taking Cincinnati's money, think again.
He will H&R Block you and take another look at you and then snort derisively.
Hey, everybody.
Zets.
Pleasure commentating with you.
Yep. Thanks for... Get out of here, Seffy. Waffles.
Give me my TV.
No,
okay.
Not like this.
Oh, yeah, let's read some last-minute commentary. All right, thanks to thanks to everybody who popped in and kept up with us on the stream during these last crucial moments. This was awesome. Thanks to, let's get this over here.
Just a cable box.
Yeah, we got the Realist Prodigy. We got Evan. We got Lumpy Gravy.
Super Knack.
OLA. Oh yeah, Deep Fox was here. Crunchyroll, the Prince. No.
Did you have fun?
Jaguar 082, who is sorry, 002, who was with us pretty much the entire day. What a trooper. Bobbleger.
Bobaloo.
All right. That's pretty much it. All right, well, we got to get out of here because the venue's shutting down inside of like 20 minutes. We got a lot of stuff to get back to people. But thanks so much, everybody. And remember, though, if you liked what you saw today, we're going to be doing this kind of stuff a lot more often here on Co-opted Live. Check us out at, go ahead and favorite us here at Co-opted Live on Twitch. And if you're interested in finding out where this is going to be posted up on YouTube, that'll be on MatchStick Melee. It's exactly what it is at the bottom of the screen there. And if you're interested in our funny Let's Play series, kind of a Mystery Science Theater 3000 for video games, you can check us out at Co-opted. The link to the YouTube channel is right there in the blue box. That concludes our broadcast day. I don't know. Everyone have a good night, and to all the ships at sea. Later.